back to this online service. I hope you guys had a wonderful week, and it's so great to see you again. We have so many fun things planned for you today, so keep watching. I have this very nice yellow microphone, and when I put this to you guys like this, that means it's time for you to answer, respond, and make some noise. So let's do a little practice round, okay? Are you ready to worship God this morning? I didn't really hear much. Let's do that one more time. Are you guys ready to worship Jesus? I think we can do a little bit better than that. Let's try that. This is our last time. Are you ready to lift up his name? Now, before we get started this morning, I want you to invite your friends, invite your brothers and sisters, invite your mom and dad. So if you haven't invited them, I'm going to give you exactly 10 seconds. So go and have them join you this morning. Okay, guys, one of my favorite things about this online worship service is that everyone at your church is all watching and worshiping together. I have a couple of friends who would like to do a shout out this morning, and they're going to share their favorite part about this online service.
Hello, my name is Jay, and I like your video of June 6, 2020. Miss Joy, thank you for the video. And I like the healing of the 10 men because you will know that Jesus will revive every single people in this earth that is hurt from the thing right now.
Before we start praise today, I want to show you a couple of motions. It goes like this. My God, it's so great. He's so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. Let's do that one more time, okay? My God, it's so great. He's so strong and so mighty that there's nothing my God cannot do. Very good. Great job. Now, let's spend some time with God.
So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot.
Heavenly Father, we live in a world where things are rocky and things are shaky, and sometimes we just don't understand why these things are happening to us. But because you are so strong and because you're so mighty and so great, we know that there is nothing that you cannot do. You're the one who is going to make impossible the possible. We give this time to you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay, guys, we're going to study the Word of God. This month in June, we're studying that Jesus is the healer. Last week, we learned how Jesus healed 10 men with a skin disease called the leprosy. There were 10 men who got healed by Jesus, but only one man returned and thanked him. We also learned that when you trust Jesus by faith, that Jesus is able to heal something that is greater than sicknesses or disease, that he is able to rescue us and save us from our sins and make us brand new again. Today's story is from Mark chapter 5. It's a story about people, how they turned to Jesus because they had a problem. All these problems they had for years that they could not solve on their own, and no one else could help them. So they knew that it was Jesus who was able to help them. Today's story, it's called Jesus Healed a Woman and a Girl. So let's find out why they needed Jesus' help.
Jesus stood on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, and a large crowd gathered around him. Jairus, one of the leaders in the synagogue, fell at Jesus' feet and begged for his help. "My daughter is about to die. Please come touch her so she will be healed and live," he said. Jesus went with Jairus, and many people followed, crowding around him. In the crowd was a woman who had been bleeding for 12 years. She had seen many doctors and had spent all her money trying to get better, but no one could help her. She was getting worse. The woman said to herself, "If I touch even Jesus' clothes, I will be healed." She came up behind Jesus in the crowd and touched his clothes. Immediately, her bleeding stopped and she knew she was healed. At that moment, Jesus felt that power had gone out of him. He turned around. "Who touched my clothes?" he asked. Jesus' disciples pointed out that many people were crowded around him, but Jesus kept looking around. The woman, knowing she was healed, came forward and fell before Jesus. She told him what had happened. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. You are healed." While Jesus was speaking, some men came from Jairus' house and told Jairus, "Your daughter is dead. Do not bother Jesus anymore." Jesus heard what the men said, and he told Jairus, "Do not be afraid. Just believe." Jesus and three of his disciples went to Jairus' house. People there were crying and wailing loudly. "Why are you crying?" Jesus asked. "The child is not dead. She is sleeping." The people laughed because they did not believe Jesus, and he told them all to leave. Jesus took Jairus and his wife into the room where the child was. He took the girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, get up." Immediately, the girl got up and began walking around. Jairus and his wife were amazed. Jesus told them to give the girl some food and to not tell anyone what had happened. By healing the woman and raising the little girl from the dead, Jesus showed his power as the Messiah. Jesus died on the cross and rose again to save people from sin and death. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sins and changes us to be more like his Son.
When people heard that Jesus had this mighty power to heal people, they started inviting their friends and families and neighbors who needed healing from Jesus. And this one man came to Jesus to ask Jesus to heal his dying daughter. Do you remember his name? That's right, Jairus. Now, Jairus had faith in God that he was able to heal his dying daughter. Now, when someone believes that God is able to do something, that is called faith. and faith pleases God. Let's read. In Hebrews chapter 11, it says, together, go. And without faith, it is impossible to please him. Jesus was going to Jairus' house, and as he was walking, as he was on his way, he felt someone touching him. That's right, a woman. Do you know why he touched Jesus? Let's read today's word, chapter 5, 25 through 27. And there was a woman who had a discharge of blood for 12 years, and who had suffered much under many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was no better, but grew worse. She had heard the reports about Jesus, and came up behind him in the crowd, and touched his garment. The woman had been suffering for 12 years. Now, that's a really long time. How old are you? 6, 8, 10? Now, since you were born, and all the way, if you're 10, you still haven't reached the 12th year. That's a very long time. And she had hope that Jesus was the only one that could heal her. You remember? She did everything else, and no one and nothing could heal her. So she had faith in Jesus. And do you know what happened? That's right. She was completely healed. And let's read this together. This is what Jesus said to her. Verse 34, go. Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. While all this was going on, Jairus received news that his daughter had just died. Now, how do you think he felt? He probably felt horrible and upset and disappointed and just as if he lost everything. Do you know what Jesus said to him? Let's read. While he was still speaking, there came from the ruler's house someone who said, your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further? But overhearing what they said, Jesus said to the ruler of the synagogue, do not fear, only believe. Jesus went to Jairus' house and he completely healed his daughter. When Jesus healed the woman and also healed Jairus' daughter from the dead, Jesus showed his ultimate power that he is the healer. That's right. What's the theme of this month? Jesus the healer. Jesus not only heals illnesses and sicknesses, but he also saves us from our sins. Jesus died on the cross so that he can make us all brand new again. When we believe in faith, Jesus comes in our heart and he cleans us and he changes our heart so that we can follow just like him. What we're going to do now is we're going to enter a time of prayer. We're going to ask God for peace and healing. Let's all pray together. Dear Jesus, the words of mercy that you showed to the women with the bleeding problem are the same words of mercy that we want to hear. You said, go in peace, you have been healed. We look to you for peace and we ask to heal all of our sufferings. Thank you so much for coming to this earth to save us. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name we all pray, amen.
Jesus, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided.
challenge you this week. I know we're all busy and sometimes we're just lazy, okay? But when someone stops you and asks for help, I want you to say these three things. You're going to say, sure, absolutely, I would love to help. Today's story, you know, when Jesus was on his way to Jairus' house, a woman stopped him. What did Jesus say? Jesus did not say, no, I'm busy, I have to go somewhere. He immediately stopped and he helped her and he completely healed her. We're going to be just like Jesus. When someone stops you and interrupts you, even if you don't want to, you're going to take an opportunity to help that person, and that's an opportunity to be more like Jesus. Okay, guys, this is it for this week. Now, if you know anyone who does not know about this online service, I want you to share the link so that they can discover and find out our true healer, our Jesus. Now, what were the three things that you're supposed to say when someone stops you and asks for help? Wonderful. Well, remember, and I will see you next week. Take care.